Welcome back from the break. Tonight we are continuing our team coverage of red tide in southwest Florida right now. Our last report was on Sanibel Island, where multiple tests have come back with medium or high amounts of red tide. But as you can see, we are now moving inland along the Caloosahatchee River, where Fox 4's Caitlin Knapp is joining us tonight.
And while some FWC tests are showing high red tide traces, some areas in Lee County, though, are not feeling the full effects of the algae blooms.
That's right. Local nonprofit, the Caloosa Waterkeeper, is telling our Caitlin Knapp today what people can do to mitigate a bloom right now.
It's pretty dynamic as to where it's at.
Red tide, John Cassani with Caloosa Waterkeeper says, is across at least 1,000 square miles in southwest Florida waterways.
It's out there in various densities.
Densities, as in how much is detected from water samples. Some areas,
it's getting up the medium high levels now.
Such as?
Bunche Beach would have high enough salinity to support Karenia typically.
Being here right now, you can't really smell anything or see any fish kill on the ground. However, again, this doesn't mean that red tide isn't around in this area.
According to a weekly report by the Sanibel Captiva Conservation Foundation, samples show medium levels of red tide at Bunche Beach.
The systemic effects of a lingering red tide after, you know, devastation by Hurricane Ian are just really a nightmarish consideration.
People I talked to off camera tell me they're concerned what this is going to do not only to our wildlife, but an already battered tourism season.
What mitigation efforts can be done?
I think it's really going to be difficult to mitigate it in any way on the short term.
Cassani says the biggest reason is because how widespread this is.
The bloom moves around with the wind, the currents, the tide, etc.
In his opinion, long-term mitigation could be.
One paradigm is, you know, think globally, act locally kind of thing. So reduce your energy footprint, reduce your consumption footprint.
But for now, Cassani says we have to ride this out.
But it looks like it's going to be here for a while.
In Lee County, Caitlin Knapp, Fox 4.